Natalie Skiba. Zachary Staples. Robert Waters. Alaysia Williams. Congratulations to all 10th grade honor students. J.K. Rowling, the British writer most well known for the Harry Potter series, once offered this thought on failure. The knowledge that you have emerged wiser and stronger from setbacks means that you are, ever after, secure in your ability to survive. You will never truly know yourself or the strength of your relationships until both have been tested by adversity. We cannot continue to excel without remaining true to ourselves and to our principles. Such is the message in the words of David Harold Fink and William Arthur Ward, which Elizabeth Pantoja will share with us. Yourself. You owe to yourself the action that opens the doors, that opens for you the doors to the goodness, the variety, and the excitement of effort and success, of battle and victory. Making payment on this debt to yourself is the exact opposite of selfishness. You can best pay your debt to society that has made you what you are by just being yourself with all your might and matter of course. You fulfill the promise that lies latent within you by keeping the following promises. I will do more than belong, I will participate. I will do more than care, I will help. I will do more than believe, I will practice. I will do more than forgive, I will forget. I will do more than teach, I will inspire. I will do more than dream, I will work. I will do more than give, I will serve. I will do more than earn, I will enrich. I will do more than live, I will grow. I will do more than be fair, I will be kind. I will do more than be a citizen, I will be a patriot. I will do more than be friendly, I will be a friend.
In the 11th grade, honors for high academic distinction over time go to Chase Arthur. Joshua Berg. Madeline Borders. Audrey Cobb. Gavin Connor. Robert Constantine. Shauna Durst.
Here.
Gianna Gallo. Julia Gorl. Bryson Kelly. Madison Kelch. Gia Mark. Daisy Martinez. Emma Monahan. Tyler Muskowski. Julia Murphy. Diamond O'Dowd. Caitlin Ostrander. Elena Phillips. Brian Rupture. Brian Solitsky. Liam Shanice. Matthew Totsky. Justin Toy. Jacob Ulmer.
I close my eyes and I can see a world that's waiting up for me that I call my own. Through the dark, through the door, through where no one's been before, but it feels like home. They can say it all sounds crazy. They can say I've lost my mind. I don't care, so call me crazy. We can live in the world that we design. 'Cause every night I lie in bed, the brightest colors fill my head. A million dreams are keeping me
me. You may be right, you may be wrong, but say that you'll bring Senior year is something that is long awaited, but which goes by too quickly. Students find themselves at the end of one part of their lives, looking forward to the beginning of another. They are filled with anticipation, apprehension, and excitement. Academic honors in senior year represent the highest honor that can be achieved here at Carbondale Area High School. Seniors who achieve this honor have performed consistently throughout the course of their entire four-year high school career. The following students have achieved this distinction and have earned all of the respect, admiration, congratulations, and best wishes we can extend to them.
The following seniors are honored for high academic distinction. Sophia Calzola. Sophia will pursue a degree in biochemistry and molecular biology at Elizabethtown College. Alyssa Kozla. Alyssa will attend the University of Scranton, where she will pursue a degree in biology with a focus in pre-med studies. Physician Assistant Studies at King's College. Emily Kelly. Emily will attend the University of Arizona's W.A. Frankie Honors College, where she will pursue a dual degree in astronomy and physics. University, where she will pursue a degree in athletic training on a pre-physician assistant track. Mia Perry. Mia will pursue a degree in biology at Penn State University. Alexis Price. Alexis will attend Misericordia University, where she will be enrolled in the Honors Program. Logan Colonna. Logan will attend Wilkes University, where he will pursue a degree in marketing.
Franchelise De Jesus Correa. Franchelise will pursue a degree in exercise science at Marywood University. Mackenzie Edgar. Mackenzie will attend Wilkes University, where she will pursue a degree in nursing. Tatiana Elston. Tatiana will pursue a degree in biological sciences / pre-veterinary studies at LeMoyne College. Jaden Fedorchak. Jaden will attend the Marywood University, where he will pursue a degree in writing. Caleb Pickton. Caleb will be taking a gap year to work before pursuing a degree in biology. Deanna Holbert. Deanna will attend the University of Scranton, where she will pursue a degree in engineering. Mia Marrero. Mia will pursue a degree in psychology at Lafayette College. Mackenzie will attend East Stroudsburg University, where she will pursue a degree in early childhood and special education. Rosemarie Navarrete. Rosemarie will pursue a degree in nursing at Lackawanna College. Kyle Perry. Kyle will attend Penn State University, where he will pursue a degree in civil and structural engineering. Jonathan Purvis. Jonathan will pursue a degree in computer science at the University of Scranton. Chloe Rumford. Chloe will attend Penn State University, where she'll pursue a degree in business. McKenna Sanderson. McKenna will pursue a degree in nursing at Wilkes University. Joshua Tierney. Josh will pursue a degree in exercise science at Misericordia University. Caden Watts. Caden will attend Lackawanna College, where she will pursue a degree in baking and pastry arts. Kiefer Weiss. Kiefer has obtained full-time employment with the Pennsylvania American Water Company. Logan Warmoth. Logan will attend Penn State University, where he will pursue a degree in engineering with a minor in business. Congratulations to all of the seniors on their consistent, outstanding achievement.
It is more than evident here this evening that none of us being honored would have achieved what we have without a strong belief in ourselves and in our own abilities. We cannot continue to excel without remaining true to ourselves and to our principles and without daring to dream. We will now present the top three students in each class with a medal in recognition of their outstanding academic excellence. In the seventh grade, the bronze medal for academic achievement goes to Ryan Waters. Sarah. The Silver Medal for Outstanding Scholarship in the 8th grade is awarded to William Murphy. The number one student in the 8th grade and the recipient of the Gold Medal for Academic Excellence is Olivia Lawler. In the 9th grade, two bronze medals for academic achievement go to Alyssa Bunk and Abigail Wong. The silver medal for outstanding scholarship in the 9th grade goes to Caitlin Burns. And the recipient of the Gold Medal for Academic Excellence is awarded to Hong Tran. In the 10th grade, the silver medals for academic achievement and outstanding scholarship go to Kylie Kelly and Molly Kelly. The number one student in the 10th grade and the recipient of the Gold Medal for Academic Excellence is awarded to Megan Koslow. In the 11th grade, the bronze medal for academic achievement goes to Robert Constantine. The silver medal for outstanding scholarship in the 11th grade goes to Julia Murphy. The number one student in the 11th grade and the recipient of the Gold Medal for Academic Excellence is awarded to Brian Rupture. Consistent academic achievement over 4 years, the Carbondale Area High School Class of 2022 awards its bronze medal to Ellen Higdon. The Class of 2022's Silver Medal for Outstanding Scholarship is presented to salutatorian Emily Kelly. awarded the gold medal for academic excellence over 4 years and is hereby named the valedictorian of the class. As this program draws to a close and we strive for continued achievement and fulfillment, we remind you that excellence can be attained if you care more than others think is wise, risk more than others think is safe, dream more than others think is practical, and expect more than others think is possible. We would like to take this opportunity to offer our most heartfelt thanks to our parents, family, friends, mentors, and teachers for insisting that we set high expectations and for encouraging us to care, to risk, and to dream. Following a few brief remarks from our principal, Mr. Gabriel will introduce Ms. Teresa Dombrowski, this evening's faculty speaker.
Before I introduce our speaker this evening, I'd like to thank Mrs. Ruggiero, our Director of Guidance, and Mrs. Warhol, our counselor, for putting on stage. And each of the tonight's ceremonies, we're all invited to the cafeteria for refreshments. It is my distinct honor and privilege to introduce our guest speaker this evening. This year's Academic Honors Night speaker is Ms. Teresa M. Dombrowski. Ms. Dombrowski is the daughter of the late John J. and Bernadette Dombrowski, two of the kindest people I've been fortunate enough to meet. She's the youngest sister of Kim, Amy, Greg, and Jeremy. Side note, Jeremy's probably my favorite, but that's a story for another day. Ms. Dombrowski is the proud aunt of Chelsea, Emma, Joshua, Bell, Jacob, Jordan, and the godmother to Emma, Jordan, Luke, and West. Her family is her world, and I've always admired her for that. Ms. Dombrowski is a 1999 honors graduate of Sacred Heart Junior Senior High School. She earned a Bachelor of Arts degree in English with a minor in Religious Studies from Marymount University. Ms. Dombrowski went on to earn her teaching certificate in secondary English from Marymount University and later a master's degree in classroom technology from Wilkes University. She began her teaching career in the fall of 2005 in the Gardner area, and we are extremely fortunate to have her on our team. In her early years of teaching, she was a drama club advisor. She moved on to become co-advisor of student council. Most recently, she has taken on being the advisor of our school newspaper, the Red and Blue News, which we are extremely proud of. Ms. Dombrowski is a passionate educator who has a knack for skillfully demanding the absolute best from her students, nothing less, while at the same time applying a kind, caring, and compassionate approach. Her talent as a master educator has earned the respect of her students and colleagues alike, hence her invitation to speak this evening. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in welcoming one of Cardinal Mary's finest, Ms. Teresa Dombrowski.
Hello, everyone. Standing here in front of you fills me with such honor and pride. I most certainly never thought that this opportunity would present itself. When the children of the Dale filed into my classroom to ask me if I would be willing to be their speaker, the only words I could form were, "I'd be honored." Trust me, I am a woman of many words, but knowing that I had been chosen, paused my ever-witty mouth for a moment, and my heart was overjoyed. Once those unknown feelings made their way out of my body, I was left with the thought of words. Yeah, words I can do, but what in the world am I going to wear? It's actually humorous because I can remember McKenna Sanderson asking me in eighth grade just how big my closet actually is. McKenna, truth is, I don't only have one girlfriend. It's more like 5. Love you, ask my brother Greg. 6, 7, 8. I know, yikes, but I do love a discount of an amazing dress, Exhibit A. But in all seriousness, thank you for choosing me. I'm so excited. It's not often that I actually get to share one of my own written pieces with my students or anyone else for that matter. When you become my student, you also become my child of the Dale. You quickly realize that our time together is filled with a process on repeat. We begin with the top-down web, move on to organizing ideas into two-column notes, drafting a rough draft or sloppy copy, and finish up with peer review before writing that polished or flawless copy for grading. When I think of this process that I drill into your minds, I can't help but be filled with a comparison of the writing process to life's journey. Let me ask you a question. When you are looking into reading a book or writing an essay, do you want to know the ending first, or would you rather read the pages and the chapters as you go and eventually make your way through to the ending? I most certainly cringe when someone tells me that they have read the last page of a book before they begin. Why on earth is this a thing? Why would anyone want to know the ending before they want to know the beginning? It blows my mind. It absolutely, positively blows my mind. Blows my mind. There's no way I would ever want to be tasked with knowing the ending before knowing where the beginning starts. It just doesn't make sense. I think back to the days of looking at your faces in eighth grade with blank stares, trying to figure out what topic you were going to pick to map out in that top-down web, relying strictly on the process I taught you until it became second nature. The truth is, without knowing it, you have used this process to write your life story. You have picked up that pen and pencil and put it back down and have written your life story a billion times over. You have chosen your attention grabbers, thesis statements, transitions, topic sentences, supporting sentences, concluding sentences, without ever truly thinking about the ending. Your introduction to this chapter of your life began when you made your journey across the parking lot to seventh grade. And unknowingly, you have continued to write, draft, peer review, and publish on repeat until the moment you applied to college, decided to join a branch of the military, or pursue a trade. Isn't it amazing to think that you, yes, you, had the power within you all along to write and craft your story the way you wanted it from the beginning? Yes, you have the power of the mighty pen. It is you that has been entrusted to write your ending as well. Don't let the fear of failure stand in the way of writing the perfect ending for yourselves. You have already begun to write the next chapter of your life, but promise me this, promise me, that you will take moments to slow down and enjoy the journey. That you will try and run that mile that seems a heck of a lot longer than 2,000 steps. Finish that essay or novel you tried to start to write 1,000 times over, just finish it. Get the application, finish it, and apply to a graduate school that's out of your league. Apply for that promotion you think you're never going to get. And will you please finally ask out that guy or girl you have been stalking from afar? Yes, stalking. By the way, it's still illegal in all 50 states, and you know who you are. These expectations will most certainly lead you to writing exciting, eye-catching, and engaging elements of your story. On a serious note, I must caution you for a moment. Think back to when it was time to peer review your writing. You would always want the perfect person you could count on to improve it. You must choose your peer reviewers in life cautiously. Right now, I'm searching for mine. My people, my family, my biggest supporters, my peer reviewers, most of whom are in this room tonight with me, while others are listening from above. Without their constant love and encouragement, I'd be a shell of the woman who stands here in front of you tonight. They are the reason I believe in me. They are also the reason I am able to support each and every one of you to believe in yourselves and your abilities. Because no matter how outlandish my ideas or crazy my imagination finds me, they are there in my corner. No questions asked. Well, I mean, like, almost no questions asked. Doing everything they can to make my dreams become a reality. They have helped me to notice my misspellings, fragments, and run-ons. But most importantly, they've helped guide me to know what all of my chapters in life should look like. Excuse me. Where my life's journey and story is possibly headed, and how it may possibly end. As you continue to write your story, think of the peer reviewers you want in your corner. The ones who will help you get to that last punctuation mark of your final chapter. The ones that will be there long after the ink dries on the page. These are the same people who should make you aware of your errors and help you correct them rather than let you turn in an assignment for grading without offering any help, but rather taking what you can offer them in return. And by the way, that is rude. So, my lovely children of the Dale, again, I ask you, if you could know the ending of your story before the beginning, would you want to know it? I can answer this without hesitation, because if everything I had mapped out for myself and planned in high school came to be, I'd own my own dance studio. Yes, I said dance studio. I'm choking, I'm sorry. I'd be teaching elementary school. Can you all imagine that for a moment in time? The owner of my own daycare, because believe it or not, I'm the best snuggler there is. Or maybe even a pediatric nurse working in a NICU. But isn't it funny? Isn't it funny how life turns out? Isn't it funny how sometimes our chapters or endings write themselves? I never imagined myself teaching high school students or the subject of English for that matter. But if I didn't take the risk, if someone didn't believe in me, I would have been lost on this journey called life. I would have never known the greatness of the miracles that take place within my classroom. Yes, I said miracles, because when my kids, my children of the Dale, finally grasp the concept we've been working on, it surely is a miracle. I know that there is a miracle. Sorry. I know that there is a miracle inside each and every one of you, just waiting for the moment you find it. The moment you put your fears aside and see it. The moment you finally believe in you. The moment you write that flawless draft. That's the moment you find your miracle. It happens for me when I hear the words, oh, Misty, 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 Misty. I know, pick me, pick me, pick me, Misty. That's a proper adjective. Oh, wait, 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 Misty. Wait, give me a second. It's coming to me. I get it. I got it. Oh, triple P, plural possessive pronoun. And let me tell you something that is such sweet music to my ears when I hear it, and I know I'm getting carried away. I know I am. But miracles happen when we least expect them to. You need to believe in you. I believe in you. I believe in your story. And I believe that you will pick up your pen or pencil and start writing every page in your own way. And you and I both know that you will edit often, but in the end, you will be proud of the version of you that you have written. So I leave you with this tonight. When given the opportunity to know the ending first, pass on it. Live in the moment, live in the now, and write the story you were meant to write. You are the author. You have the power. Now go and write your story. Thank you.
Thank you.